There's only one NFC team left undefeated, and today they walk into AT&T Stadium wearing red and looking to make it 6-0. Meanwhile, on the other side, aiming to end that run will be Michael Gallup and the 2-2 Dallas Cowboys. First play of the day for Dallas, and Dak Prescott fakes the give and has Tyler Higbee wide open for 23 yards across midfield. Three plays later, and it's the player we just mentioned in the opener as Prescott stands in and hits Michael Gallup for 16 yards on 3rd and 6. Dallas facing third down again, and this time it's Prescott to Cedric Wilson over the middle for 13 yards to set up 1st and goal. And on 2nd and goal from the 1, Prescott's throwing and he goes to the end zone, but it's intercepted by Foye Aluikin, and the Ivy League linebacker is going to bring it out, returning the pick to the Atlanta 24-yard line, and Aluikin's first career interception results in the Dallas opening drive coming up empty. Then on Atlanta's next play, Gilbert fakes the give, fires down the seam to Kyle Woods, but it's off his hands and intercepted. Xavier Woods brings it back into Atlanta territory, and the Dallas offense takes right back over. Then facing 3rd and 6 from the 38, Prescott throwing, and his pass is going to be broken up by Kendall Sheffield to bring up 4th down. Field goal unit comes on, and the former Falcon Matt Bryant nails the 55-yarder and gives the Cowboys an early 3-0 lead. Falcons looking to answer, and on 3rd and 8, Gilbert completes his first pass to Calvin Ridley for 12 yards to convert. Two plays later, Devontae Freeman with the give, and he has 15 yards and a 1st down across midfield. Then after another 1st down, Gilbert looking to throw, and he's got Ridley again for 18 yards down to the Dallas 16. And on 2nd and 1 from the 7, it's Gilbert back to Ridley, who's right to the goal line, but comes up just shy of a touchdown, which sets up Casey Rivers scoring from 1 yard out to break the Falcons' rookie rushing touchdown record and give them a 7-3 lead. Ensuing drive, Cowboys near midfield where Prescott fakes and looks to throw before firing into double coverage where it's intercepted by Keanu Neal, and shout out to Chris Berman because whoop! Neal puts on the brakes and sends a Cowboys lineman flying as he returns his 3rd interception of the year, 58 yards for the pick 6 and a 14-3 Falcons lead. Atlanta gets it right back and are on the move as Gilbert finds Mecole Hardman wide open for the 1st down and 18 yards to start the drive. Next play, Gilbert throwing again and has Austin Hooper wide open, but he throws it right to Kyler Fackrell, and suddenly Dallas takes over at the Atlanta 33. And on Dallas's first play, it's Prescott faking the give, and he's got Amari Cooper wide open down the middle for a 33-yard touchdown as the Cowboys make it 14-10. Falcons turn again, and facing 3rd down, Gilbert stands in and fires into heavy coverage where it's deflected and intercepted again. It's Trayvon Mullen this time, and Dallas once again takes over in Atlanta territory, but now with a chance to take the lead. And on the following play, Prescott fakes again, and he's going right back to the end zone where Deuce clicks on, but nothing happens, and it's another one play score. And in a matter of seconds, the Falcons go from leading by 11 to trailing by 3. First play of the ensuing drive, and the craziness continues as Devontae Freeman finds a lane, is into the clear and across midfield for 37 yards. Two plays later, and Gilbert has Calvin Ridley over the middle for 17 more down to the Dallas 12. Then facing 3rd and 22 from the 24, Gilbert throwing for Kyle Woods, and Byron Jones looks like Superman diving in to make the pick, and the disastrous quarter continues for Gilbert and the Falcons as they turn it over again. Cowboys looking to punish, and on their second play, it's Prescott faking and finding Dalton Schultz for 10 yards and a 1st down. Three plays later, 3rd and 7, and Prescott is right on the money to Amari Cooper for 25 yards into Atlanta territory. And on the following play, Prescott fires quick out to Michael Gallup, who jukes Isaiah Oliver, beats 2 Falcons to the sideline, and outraces half the defense for a 43-yard score, and the Cowboys make it 21 unanswered points in the 2nd quarter as they now lead 24-14. Dallas gets it right back, and this is not an echo you're about to hear, just Swiss cheese Atlanta defense as Prescott hits Tyler Higbee for 16 yards on a 1st down. Next play, Prescott looking to throw again, and he's going to hit Tyler Higbee, who has another 17 yards and 1st down into Atlanta territory. Then out of the 2-minute warning, Prescott throwing, and it's Tyler Higbee for 19 more and another Dallas 1st down. Next play, and it's Prescott to Tyler Higbee, who's just shy of the 1st down marker. And on the following play, it's Prescott to none other than Tyler Higbee, who makes 5 consecutive catches for 70 yards and a touchdown, and 28 points in the second quarter sends Dallas to the break with a 31-14 lead. Then to start the second half, it takes only one play for the Cowboys to cross midfield as Ezekiel Elliott has 22 yards on the first down. Three plays later, and it's right back to Elliott, who squeezes through and has another 20-yard gain down to the Falcons' 15-yard line. And then on third and seven, Atlanta finally gets a stop, but by no doing of their own as Dak Prescott overthrows Amari Cooper. Matt Bryant comes on and easily hits the 30-yard field goal and make it 31 unanswered now and a 20-point Dallas lead. Later in the third, same score, and the Cowboys are driving again as Ezekiel Elliott has 11 yards on the first down. Next play, and Prescott has Amari Cooper on the slant, who's thrown forward and tumbles down for a 17-yard gain. Next play again, and the chains keep moving as Prescott hits Tyler Higbee for 10 yards on a first down at the Atlanta 16. Then three plays later, third and 10, Prescott looks to throw and stands in with all day before eventually going short to Cedric Wilson, who's taken down for a 1-yard gain. Matt Bryant comes on and makes it 3 for 3 on the day, and with the fourth quarter looming, the Cowboys now have a 23-point lead. Falcons have to do something, and to start the fourth quarter, it's Gilbert to Casey Rivers, who's just shy of the marker. And on third and two, Rivers takes the give, looks like he has the first down, but the refs rule he's short, and when it rains, it pours, as on fourth and inches, Casey Rivers can't get forward, and the Cowboys take over. Atlanta down 26 now, and needing a miracle, it's second and 16, where Gilbert goes short to Casey Rivers, who jukes one defender and is up the sideline for a 42-yard gain into Dallas territory. Two plays later, and it's Gilbert right back to Rivers for 13 more and another Falcons first down. Two plays later again, and Gilbert stands in before going downfield to Mecole Hardman for 22 yards to make it first and goal. And on the following play, Gilbert throwing again and moving to his right, where Kyler Fackrell takes him down for the sack. So second and goal from the 13, where Gilbert stands in, navigates the pocket, and finds Mecole Hardman in the back of the end zone for the touchdown. And after 37 unanswered points from Dallas, Atlanta is finally back on the board to make it 40-21. However, they would not threaten a comeback, but with under a minute to go, Gilbert does find Austin Hooper on fourth and goal for a 9-yard score. But what starts out looking like yet another Falcon victory turns into an absolute mauling as Dallas racks up nearly 500 yards, forces four turnovers, and sends the Falcons to their first defeat of the 2021 season. Atlanta will look to regroup as they stay on the road and head to Arizona next week to face the Cardinals. Well, that was pretty rough. Everything started out well and was looking good, and then all of a sudden just completely turns, and I just couldn't really do anything except make mistakes. Couldn't stop them on defense, and then offensively they had that combination of a superstar edge rusher and a superstar corner, so you're constantly under pressure and basically can't throw to one side of the field either, so it made things really tough. But also making things tough was losing Grady Jarrett, who went down with a shoulder tear and will miss the next four games, so another tough blow, as two of our best players on both sides of the ball now are out with injuries. But this will pave the way for rookie second rounder Kari Richmond to get some playing time, so it'll be interesting to see what he can do. We only had one new negotiation this week, and it resulted in Austin Traylor signing a 2-year, $3 million contract with $700K guaranteed. Traylor has been a good backup and filled in nicely for Austin Hooper last year and is still somewhat young as well. And then I can't possibly let a 69 overall hit the open market, can I? Moving along here, we have a pair of draft tweets this week, starting with one from Ross Tucker that refers to Oregon State left guard Chris Ogle and reads, "Opposing D-lines are having their way with Ogle right now. To keep his place in the draft, he needs to toughen up." And then we have a second one here from Mark Schlereth that references Mississippi State outside linebacker Sylvester Powers and reads, "Sylvester Powers goes from defensive star to liability depending on the week. Strange season for him." So looking at this week's draft board additions, we start with left tackle Keenan Shelton, who is a first-round projection as well as true talent. Then we have another left tackle in Rajon Colvin out of Boston College, who is a second-round projection and true talent. And then lastly below them are Chris Ogle and Sylvester Powers, who you just saw in this week's draft tweets. Lastly here for the team side is player upgrades, where we start with center Justin Britt, who goes up to a 76 overall with 1 point increases to his impact block, pass block power, and strength. Following him is rookie wide receiver Kyle Woods, who will have his hidden dev revealed next video, and he goes up to a 75 overall with plus ones to his catch in traffic, catching, and short route running, as well as a 2-point increase to his medium route running. Linebacker Justin Hollins, who we signed from the Broncos practice squad last video, becomes the newest member of the 69 club after a 2-point increase to his finesse moves. Next up is Jordan Miller, who remains a 68 overall and is denied admission to the 69 club, but he still receives 1 point towards his play rec and a nice 3-point bump to his zone coverage. And then lastly, we have outside linebacker Mitchell Hodel, who goes up 1 point on acceleration, man coverage, and play rec, and then gets 3-point increases to both tackle and zone coverage. And now we go around the league, starting as always with league scores, where the Patriots double up Houston on Thursday night. Raiders upset the Bengals, Panthers drop the Bucks, while the Colts, Browns, and Giants all pick up home victories. Vikings win 17-10 over the Lions, Jags take down the Cardinals, and the Dolphins win by 5 in Pittsburgh. Chiefs lose to the Broncos, Titans win the Super Bowl 34 rematch, and on Sunday night the Bears win a 41-38 shootout against the Packers. And wrapping up week 6 was the Eagles getting their first win of the season, beating the Saints 31-24. A look at the AFC standings has the Patriots and Dolphins tied for first place in the East at 4-2, with the 3-2-1 Jets and 1-4 Bills trailing behind. The North is currently the Browns to lose, as they lead the way at 5-1, with the 2-3 Ravens in second place, while the Bengals and Steelers are tied for last place, each at 2-4. Same story in the South, as the 5-1 Jaguars are the only team over 500, while the 2-3-1 Texans are in second place ahead of the 2-3 Titans in third, and the last place 2-4 Colts. And leading the AFC West is the Denver Broncos with a 5-1 record, and they're a half game up on the 4-1 Beats, a full game up on the Chiefs, and 2.5 games up on the surging 2-3 Raiders. Moving to the NFC side, the Giants and Cowboys both win to move to 3-2, and they remain tied for first place in the East and well ahead of the 1-4 Redskins and 1-5 Eagles. The North is currently the Vikings to lose, as they sit at 5-1 with a 3-game lead over the second place Bears, while the 1-4 Packers and 0-6 Lions chances are all but gone after 6 weeks. Despite the loss, we still lead the South at 5-1 because the Saints lose and fall to 4-2. Panthers move to 3-3 and sit in third place, while the Buccaneers fall to 0-6 and remain in last place. Then lastly, out west, it's a complete free-for-all, as the Rams, 49ers, and Seahawks are all tied in first place with 3-2 records, while the Cardinals sit in last place just a half game back. The Week 6 Offensive Player of the Week for the AFC is the Colts' Andrew Luck. The 10th-year former number one overall pick completed all but 5 of his 35 attempts for 313 yards and found the end zone 5 times, as he led the Colts to a 42-28 victory against the Bills. Meanwhile, for the NFC, the offensive award goes to Bears running back Tariq Cohen. The 2017 fourth-round pick out of North Carolina A&T had 125 yards rushing and 2 touchdowns on just 10 carries. Cohen also added 3 catches for 53 yards and another touchdown through the air, as his Bears won 41-38 against the Packers. On the defensive side, the AFC award goes to Jets linebacker CJ Mosley. The former Alabama defender in his 8th NFL season notched 11 tackles, all of which were solo, and also dropped Browns quarterback Baker Mayfield for a sack. However, despite Mosley's award-winning performance, his Jets lost 28-20 in Cleveland. And then lastly, the NFC award goes to our very own Keanu Neal. The superstar X-Factor safety made 8 tackles and returned an interception 58 yards for a touchdown to give us a 14-3 lead, but it was followed by nothing but disaster, as we were dominated from that point on and lost 40-27 to the Cowboys. On to the league leaders, it's our own Ray Gilbert leading the way with 1,842 yards passing. Sam Darnold adds another 2 touchdowns this week and now has a league best 16, and Andrew Luck becomes the newest leader in passer rating with a league high 128.5 rating. The rushing leaders jackpot is once again no more, as Saquon Barkley still leads in rushing yards with 703 and yards per carry with a 7.6 average, but our rookie phenom Casey Rivers sets a new Falcons rookie record this week and is tops in the NFL with 7 rushing touchdowns. No changes for the receiving leaders, as Jamison Crowder continues to lead all 3 categories with a league best 41 catches, 535 yards receiving, and despite not scoring this week, he still has a league high 6 touchdown receptions. On the defensive side of the ball, all 3 leaders are the same as last week, with Dwayne McBath leading with 57 tackles. Von Miller adds another sack this week, giving him a league high 9, and the Jets' Marcus May adds another interception as well and leads the NFL with 4 picks on the year. And as we wrap up, we take a look at next week's schedule, which kicks off with the 49ers and Colts on Thursday night. Steelers head to Baltimore to face the Ravens, 3-2 Giants at the 1-5 Eagles, and then the Chiefs take their 4-1 record to Dallas to play the Cowboys. Patriots at Jets in AFC East action. Seahawks face the Redskins in a battle of the Washingtons. Dolphins go on the road and will play the Titans. And then the Saints look to bounce back as they head to Buffalo to play the 1-4 Bills. The Rams head across the country to take on 5-1 Jacksonville. The defending Super Bowl champs are 2-4 and host the 1-4 Packers. We head to Arizona to face the Cardinals while the Browns take their 5-1 record to Oakland to play the Raiders. Then wrapping up the week is an old NFC Central battle as the Bears head to Tampa Bay on Sunday night. And on Monday night, the Texans travel to Brooklyn to face the 4-1 Beats. Panthers, Broncos, Lions, and Vikings all get the week off with byes. But that's going to do it. Rough game this video, but after such a hot start to the season, we were due for a dud, and despite falling to 5-1, we still have sole control of first place in the division. Next video, we face Kyler Murray and the Cardinals looking to bounce back, so hope to see you guys all back for that. As always, I appreciate you guys.